Welcome to today's class. In this class, we are going to discuss last topic of module 2. It's nothing but maxima and minima for function of two variables. After that, you have Lagrange's undetermined multipliers. That is nothing but finding a maxima minima for function of several variables. First, we have to discuss how to find out maxima minima for function of two variables. If you want to study this, first, you have to know first order and second order partial derivatives. This maxima and minima for function of two variables are nothing but application of partial differentiation. You already discussed in our previous classes how to find out first order partial derivative and second order partial derivative with respect to independent variables. Now, before moving to explain how to find out the maxima minima for function of two variables. Now first let us recall, you already know that how to find out maxima and minima for function of one variable. Maxima and minima for function of one variable, say f of x. How to find out? First you take f of x is equal to 0, then first you take what's the given the function f of x. First, you find out the first derivative of the given function. How to find out first derivative? Here, f is only a function of one independent variable. It's dependent only one variable. Therefore, from the ordinary differentiation, find out the derivative equal to 0. After equal to 0, find out the roots of that equations. Well, the roots are nothing but x1, x2, etc. Depending upon order of the polynomial have in f dash of x, based on that we get x1, x2, x3 like that. What are the values, roots we are finding after equal to 0? These points are nothing but critical points of the given function. Once we get critical points, next you find out the, you substitute the, find out the second derivative and then substitute one by one. Then for what value of x1, we get a minimum value. You say that this is a minimum value. For what value of x1, x2, x3, we get maximum value. Then we treat it as a maximum value. Suppose you don't get it any value. Function is not a minimum, not a maximum value. You can't find out. We treated that points are saddle points. Means that gives us neither maxima nor minima for the function. These things you already studied in PU level. This is for function of one variable. Now here in this class, we are going to discuss how to find out the maxima minima for function of two variables. Instead of one variable, how many variables we are considering? Two variables. Suppose f is a function of x and y. The given f is a function of x and y, I want to find out maxima and also minima. Instead of using maxima or minima, they are going to use extremities. Find the extremities of the given function means it is enough to find out maxima and minima of the given function. Okay. Instead of one variable, how many variables you have? Two variables. We are using the same concept here, but the thing is, we are involving more than one independent variables. Therefore, we are going to take, instead of ordinary, we are going to take what? Partial derivative. That's all. Here, what we did for one variable, first you find out the critical point. How to find out the critical point? First you find out the derivative of the given function. Like that, first you find out first order partial derivative of f with respect to independent variables. What are dou f by dou x? What's another notation of dou f by dou x is fx. And also find out dou f by dou y means fy. After you find out the first derivative, what we did here, equal to 0. Here also, first you take the given function, find out the first order partial derivative of the given function with respect to independent variables, and then equal to 0. Once you equal to 0, here we get critical points are like x1, x2, x3, etc. after solving this. But here after solving fx and fy, carefully have to solve, we get a critical points just like a pair x1, y1, because they are involving two variables, x2, y2, like that. The These points are nothing but critical points. Same concept we are going to using here for ordinary, but here we are going to use which definition? Partial derivative, because it's a function of more than one independent variable. After that, what I told you, I have to find out second derivative. Say here I have to find out f double dash of x. Like that, here also find out second order partial derivatives. Ordinary have only one first order, only one second order. But in the partial, is whenever function is depending upon more than one independent variable, you can't expecting one first order, one second order partial derivatives. You have a first order partial derivatives, again you find out second order partial derivatives. For example, we already discussed exclusively in the first few classes. Now f is a function of x and y. Okay. Now what are the independent variables is here x and y. First you find out first order partial derivatives. After once you get first order partial derivatives, again I have to differentiate with respect to x partially with respect to y. What are now we get dou square f by dou x square. Okay. And also what we get actually here, dou square f y with respect to x, dou x into dou y. And also take with respect to y, we get dou square f by dou y into dou x. Okay. And also dou square f by dou y, dou square f by dou y square. Okay. But we already discussed whenever f is function of two independent variables, in that case, usually dou square f by dou x into dou y must be same as dou square f by dou y into dou x. Okay. Therefore, now what we are finding a first order, second order partial derivatives, for my convenient, I'm going to choose A is nothing but dou square f by dou x square, because not only one second order partial derivatives. B is nothing but dou square f by dou x into dou y, or you have to take dou square f by dou y into dou x, both are must be same. C is nothing but my dou square f by dou y square. What are the first four second order partial derivatives we get with respect to x and y? For our convenient, we are choosing the notation is nothing but ABC. Some textbook, they taken RST. Instead of this, they taken R. Maybe here, yes, here maybe a T. No issue. Choice of you choose any one of the. Once we get a second order partial derivative, we are go for each and every critical point wherein for a function of one variable, I have to verify it. But here, not only one second order partial derivatives, we have more than one second order partial derivatives. What are A, B, and C? Therefore, we can't take a judgment based on A or B or C. Yes, you can't take a decision only based on A value or B value or C value. Here, having only one variable, therefore, we get only one f double dash of x. Easy to find out what happened at x1, x2, x3. But here, have all A, B, C are denote second order partial derivatives. You can't take a decision based on either based on A or B or C. Therefore, they framing one equation based on A, B, C is nothing but AC minus B square. Keep in mind, A is nothing but dou square f by dou x square. C is nothing but dou square f by dou y square. B is nothing but dou square f by dou x into dou y, or dou square f by dou y into dou x. I told these two are equal, therefore they taken A, B square. The framing one of the relation is nothing but AC minus B square. Now they are going to verify AC minus B square at each and every part. Okay. Suppose I am going to take AC minus B square. Before going to find out AC minus B square, first you find out, at, for example, I'm going to take first point, say, at x1, y1. At x1, y1, first critical point, I have to find out what is my A value, what is my B value, what is my C value, okay? After that, I have to verify that what happened AC minus B square. Once you frame an equation, AC minus B square, there are three possibilities. AC minus B square is greater than 0, less than 0, maybe equal to 0. This expression, value may be greater than, may be positive, may be negative, may be equal to 0. Now, first I'm going to take first possibility is nothing but AC minus B square is greater than 0. Suppose AC minus B square is 0 for that point x1, y1, immediately verify there are two possibilities. Suppose AC minus B square greater than 0, immediately verify A. Suppose A is greater than 0, observe carefully, AC minus B square is greater than, before that you know what is the value of A. This is greater than 0 and also A is positive, then we say that at x1, y1 function is minimum. F of x, y is minimum. Okay. Suppose AC minus B square is greater than 0, A is less than 0, then we say that at the point x1, y1, f of x, y is maximum. F of x, y is maximum. Once you clear this chart thing, then easy to solve the problem. Maximum. Okay. This is a thing is happen maximum, minimum. The case is AC minus B square itself must be a positive. But what's other possibility? AC minus B square may be a negative. AC minus B square is negative. Now I'm going to write at the point. What's the point? X1, y1, the function is f of x, y is neither maximum nor minimum. It's neither max or minimum, nor minimum. Okay. The another possibility is AC minus B square itself is 0. Itself is 0, then you write at this particular point. What's a particular point? Say, what a point I taken here? X1, y1. Further investigation is required. Just you write that. No need to do the further investigation. Investigation is required. I think it's clear how to verify function is maxima or minima for function of two variables. How to find out what you know that in for one variable, same thing. First, you find out first order partial derivatives and then equal to 0. Once you equal to 0, but not just like for one variable, carefully have to evaluate, solve this equation, find out the critical points. We get a critical points just like x1, y1 pair, x2, y2, x3, y3 like that. After we get critical points, how to proceed, you find out second order partial derivatives. Here you don't get it one second order. For our convenient, choose fxs is nothing but a, fxy or fxy are nothing but b, fyy is nothing but c. But you can't take addition either based on a or b, c. The framing one of the relation is nothing but, expression is nothing but ac minus b square. Once you frame the expression ac minus b square, there are three possibilities. This value may be greater than 0, may be negative value, may be equal to 0. Now, suppose I choose one of the points, say x1, y1, one of the critical points, what we already, just assume that we already calculated. At the point, you first you find out ABC. Once we get ABC, then verify this expression. Just assume AC minus B square is positive. AC minus B square is positive. Before that, and at the point, you know what is my A. A also positive. Observe carefully. A, this is positive, A is positive, then we say that at the point x1, y1, f of x, y is minimum. Suppose AC minus B square is positive, A is less than 0, then we consider that the corresponding point x1, y1, f of x, y is a maximum. Okay. Suppose this expression itself is less than 0, then we consider f of x, y is at that point neither maximum nor minimum. Okay. Suppose the expression itself is 0, just you write the further investigation is required in the corresponding point. Not necessary or no need to do the further investigation. This way, I have to verify whether they are having extremities or not for the function of two variables. Before moving to the problem, I want to show the flow chart. After end up, once you are complete entire module, I'm going to share the PPT presentation also. You go through that. Then easy to remember what are the things I explained just now. Entire thing I displayed in the flowchart. Then once you know this flow chart, then enter the maximum minima working rule, we get it. Okay, first you start means first you have a z is a function of what actually is a function of two variables. Is it clear or not? Actually is a function of two variables. Now is it just a minute before you please be bear with 1 second. I'm going to take whatever PDF thing in the Microsoft Whiteboard, then easy to mark the steps. Okay. Just a minute. I'm showing entire thing in I think is visible. I'm showing entire flow chart in my whiteboard, Microsoft Word whiteboard. Okay, first you start means what they given here. They given f is a z is a, instead of f of x y, they assign one of the variables z. Z is a function of x and y. How to start? First you find a first order partial derivative of z with respect to what are the independent variables x and y. That's the thing we did, dou z by dou x and dou z by dou y. What we have the next step? The next step is observability. This is a thing what we mentioned. Okay, this is also error mark. Okay, now here solve equal to 0, dou z by dou x equal to 0, dou z by dou y equal to 0. Solve carefully, we get a some set of pair of values is nothing but x1, y1, x2, y2, etc. How many pair of values depends upon the equating dou z by dou x and dou z by dou y equal to 0. After that, you find out the second order partial derivative. What is my second order partial derivative here? Dou square by dou square f by dou x square, dou square f by dou x into dou y, or dou square f by dou y into dou x, and also dou square f by dou y square. For our convenience, we choose a, b, c, and then at each and every set, we already taken all points. I take make it at yes in my flow chart. For each x I y I take it from yes. Find out a c minus b square. Once you find out AC minus B square, I return possibility. Find out AC minus B square. Once AC minus B square is greater than 0, immediately verify A value. Suppose AC minus B square greater than 0, A is greater than 0, then what we are going to do here, now we are going to give a conclusion at the point x, y, y, the function is minima. They're having a minimum. You know how to find a minimum value. Just substitute the x, xi, yi in the given function, we get the corresponding minimum value. Suppose ac minus b square is greater than 0, a is not greater than 0, a is less than 0, then we say that the function at the corresponding point, the function is maxima, and then you find out the corresponding maximum value using what actually using the given function f of x y. Okay, this is based on ac minus b square. Suppose ac minus b square is not greater than 0, there are two possibilities, maybe less than 0, maybe equal to 0. Suppose ac minus b square is at that point x y y is less than 0, then we say that at to stop, we have to say that this is saddle point. Saddle point at x at the corresponding point. X, Y, Y, Y means the function is neither maximum nor minimum. Means, is it clear or not? Function is neither what I told in my theory explanation, saddle point is nothing but the another way to write the function is neither maximum nor minimum. Suppose AC minus B square at the point X, Y, Y is not greater than 0, not less than 0. What's the possibility? No, it may be AC minus B square is equal to 0. Equal to 0. Just you write further investigation required, but not necessary to write the further investigation. You continue this process, observe carefully. continue this process until, please try to understand. No, after that, you again you come to this. You please try to understand. No, you further investigation. Okay, fine. No, then again you move this flow chart. You come to where xi by i belongs to s. Take next point, next order pair is nothing but x2 y2. Again you calculate ac minus b square. Continue this process until all the solution is processed. Means all the critical points you are all used. You process this flow chart until complete all the elements of the set. Yes. Suppose you all solutions are processed. Yes, then we are going to stop to do this flow chart. Flow chart for based on the set of elements of S. This give rise extremities or maxima minima for function of two variables. This is a working rule for maxima and minima for function of two variables. For student benefit, I express entire theory in the flow chart. Yeah, everyone is familiar with the flow chart. Then please write this flow chart in your notes. Then keep in mind, then easy to solve the problem. Okay, fine. Okay. Now, before I move to the next step, okay, fine. Okay. Yeah. Now, I want to show another thing. How to look like maxima minima for function of two variables. Okay. Now, once you complete that, I move to the problem. I move to the problem in the next class. Okay. I'm going to solve few problems based on that. Okay. Yeah, observe carefully this maxima minima, how this look like. Maxima minima, how the maxima, how is look like in 3D figure, how is look like minima for a 3D figure. Okay, this is a way, this is I'm showing that graphical representation in 3D figure I taken in some one of the article. How is look like maxima minima? Suppose you represent in a plot a graph in 3D view. How is look like our minima? How is look like maximum? Okay. Thank you very much for listening my talk. I'll come back some few problems based on maxima minima for function of two variables.